Okay, hi traders, here's a new video. First of all, the risk warning, your invested capital might be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another binary options, binary options trading, price action trading video. As you see, we have weekend and I'm a European trader. I do not have the OTC market available, so I'm doing this kind of explanation videos of those trades which I have already done, referring to those pages of the ebook which are important to understand to do those kind of trades like I'm doing them. First of all, the ebook, get this ebook. You'll find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, and binary option tool trading concepts, market condition, trend identification, rejection, and candlestick mass, and a lot of more concepts which can be applied to any kind of time frame, any kind of financial instrument, and any kind of broker. So get this ebook. You'll find the link in the description, and in the description you will find also the link to the Facebook group. Let me first of all show you those kind of pages which are important to understand before I'm gonna start with the explanation of the trades. Important again, I will show them always again and again because that are the most important one. We have first of all this kind of two videos, where I talk about the Bollinger Band, and here where I talk about the EMAs. That are the most important one to understand the indicator which you are using. Obviously, the right time, the right market conditions. That is also important. Here is an overview of this. Those kind of pages where I talk about the purchase time and the expiration time. That about the entry points. This what the next prediction of the candle is like. And the running candle. What this kind of things are meaning, you will understand if you watch the video. Then this one here, where I talk about the prediction of the next candle, which is a high probability trading setup. If you do this, what I have explained here in this kind of page of the ebook and in the related video. Then this part here where I talk about how to read the candlestick chart, how to choose the trading setup, I will show you here in detail. I will make a new series about this. Then I will show you in detail one for one how I do this on the live trading chart. I don't know when I'm gonna start this series, but it will be soon. So you understand what kind of process I'm passing when I'm doing this kind. It's already most of the parts here are already on me automatically. That means that I do not even think about this. That is running like a machine. So obviously understanding the strength of the candles. This is important. Bullish and bearish. The support and resistance levels based on candlestick patterns. The support and resistance minor support and major support and resistance levels. The change of polarity, which is really important. This one and this one. So market condition in general. And I would say that was already the most important ones. The highest probability trading setups. This kind of stuff about the reversal and retracement, fake breakout, four keys, the trends, the key level, the candlestick pattern, and the rejection. What the EMA alignment is telling you about the major and the minor trend. Then that part here about Fibonacci, not about the Fibonacci, about the market condition, strong trend, healthy trend, and consolidation area or ranging market, because every kind of different market condition, candlestick patterns, and chart patterns behave different, and that is what you should understand. That was again about rejection, and then the candlestick mass. And overall, all kind of not EMAs, all kind of candlestick patterns and chart patterns should be should be you should know them inside out. You should know them all. More at the beginning of the ebook they are, more important they are, less Later they are in the ebooks, less important they are because they will not appear so often. Something like a meeting line, yes, or a counter attack will not often appear. So it doesn't mean that is so important to know them. But if you have a doji, you know the doji or the hammer, yes, that are candlestick pattern which will happen always. Evening star, morning stars will happen always, and so they are much more important, yes, than for example the Harami, which appears all 100, 200 candles. Yes. Okay, so let's start with the video. Yes, and I'm gonna show you, or I will stop the video as soon as there is something to explain. So we have here a pre-long downtrend. Let me show you here first of all a few things which are important to understand immediately when you are. We have here a trend channel. Yes, we have here a Bollinger squeeze. We got here in a breakout. Yes, but this breakout was not strong because we have here a flat 200 EMA. So the market is almost ranging, yes, that is not a trending market, this is almost ranging, yes, because the trend is not established here, yes. Also, if we had a short trend here, yes, but this doesn't mean anything. So, and that was already everything what I should do, tell you about the market condition. Yes, we had a downtrend, we got here a pullback from the one deviation Bollinger Band. The one deviation Bollinger Band and the two deviation Bollinger Band are doing here a trend channel. The alignment of the EMAs is showing that we could go into a downtrend, yes, but the 200 EMA is still so flat. That means that price is doing this kind of behavior here, yes. This kind of behavior is due and is because of the flat 200 EMA, because then price will retrace almost and do consolidation areas almost often at key levels, yes. That is what you should understand if you see the flat 200 EMA or the flat 100 EMA, yes. That market starts often to do consolidation areas at key level, like here too. Okay, so let's start the video, and as soon as there is something to explain, I will stop the video. So let's see. So we had here a bullish, inverted bullish hammer. This inverted bullish hammer after this kind of downtrend was already a call. But because we got here this kind of support and resistance level, yes, which I have drawn due to this 3 weeks, I didn't enter into a call because the price moved up too fast. And the entry point would be back. In such kind of condition, like I have explained in the ebook, the entry point for a call would have been below the closing price of this inverted bullish hammer. The price didn't give me the possibility, and so I entered into a put at this level. So you have seen that was this one. Now we are going far away. We are going far away from the two deviation Bollinger Band, yes, but the previous candle got a rejection here. Let me show you this. The next candle got the previous candle got a rejection, yes. So that is what I have explained here. So we got a rejection here from this level. That was the reason why I didn't enter again into a put, into a call, yes, because this rejection from this area, yes, because this candle didn't unfold like I would expect what this should be after this inverted bullish hammer. This, after this inverted bullish hammer, I would expect that this candle would be some kind of stronger candle. This doesn't happen. This candle got a rejection. The lower shadow is bigger than the upper shadow is bigger than the lower shadow, and that means we have here selling pressure, and that's the reason why I didn't enter here into a call again, and that I waited. Maybe I wait. I don't know. Let me see. I will do a little bit fast forward. Yes, I waited and didn't enter into any kind of trade. So, okay, let me see what's happening then. So now we have here an engulfing candle. Yes, and after price retraced back, and you see here, it's the same scenario which I have explained in the ebook. Yes, on the engulfing candle, we have the major downtrend. We got here this signal here, or the wick, the upper shadow showed that we have selling pressure. After this, we get here a pullback of the one deviation Bollinger Band. Yes, and then I waited till price got from here above to this level. I could have been waiting much, much more. Yes, because you see, we have here this wick, and I have explained this in the ebook. You should do a trend control continuation trade almost from the previous candle opening price. Yes, in this case, yes. So if you have a downtrend, and for me, it was already the high of the previous candle closing price was already enough. And that's the reason why I entered here into a put of this kind of bearish engulfing candle in direction of the trend, which is not a strong trend, yes, but we are still between the one deviation and the two deviation Bollinger Band. That is a downtrend, still downtrend area, yes, and this engulfing candle was the reason why this got down, yes, else it would have been already the a place where price would retrace back and would do here some kind of double bottom, yes. If this candlestick would not have been, yes, this candle would not have been a bearish candle, yes, because you see already we are going far away from the two deviation Bollinger Band. This Bollinger Band is already getting flat here. That means that we are getting here in some kind of reversal, yes. And if this candle would not have been an engulfing candle, this candle would not be have been a bearish candle. It would be already a bullish one. And so this trade would have been out of the money. So, and after this, I understood from this previous doji that we are getting here out. The trend downtrend is nearly over. We are getting far away from the two deviation Bollinger Band. As for those one who don't know this, this is a two deviation Bollinger Band. You see, we got here a nice downtrend channel, yes, and then now we are getting far away, yes, from it, and that is the reason of this 200 EMA, because it's flat, the trend is not established, it's almost over, yes, and this candlestick is a weak candle after this kind of bearish engulfing candle, which would implicit that this candle would have been broken through this area, but this candle didn't broke through this area, and that was the reason for me to do a call here in this kind of condition, because I was expecting that price would do a reversal. It was a close in the money, yes, to see how important the entry point was again. So, and then I entered again into a call, because I understood that we are getting now into a double bottom, yes, because of, and I waited after the price got a rejection from the one deviation to get a better entry point, yes. The best entry point would have been below this kind of area here, below the opening price of the previous candle. But often price will not give it to you, yes. And if you wait too long, you will often not get the possibility. But I understood from this movement, the momentum upwards, that price will continue to going up. And that was the reason why I entered here into a call at this high of this opening price of the previous candle. And you see it was only a weak candle, which would implicit that the next candle would be also some kind of weak candle, and obviously not a bullish one, a bearish one. So, okay, that was already. If you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe to my channel. And if you have something to say, drop me a line in the comment section. So I would say stay safe and bye-bye.